afternoon and welcome to Alfab 17's coverage of local prep high school football. I'm Matt Greer along with Rob DeArmond and our cameraman extraordinaire up on top of the booth, Mr. Tommy Hazelwood. We are here in the swamp. First game, week one, coming off jamborees. We got Walker, we got Ponchatoula, Rob.
It's been a while since I've been to the swamp, and this is something you and I have been talking about for a few years to try to get this going, so here we are. Just really excited to get another school year going, another football season going. Should be a good matchup between these two teams. Both got a lot to play for. Both 5A teams are going to test each other right off the bat.
Absolutely. These two teams are usually powerhouses. I'm sure it'll be no different tonight. Like I said, we're in the swamp. The stands are filling up. You know how they do things in Ponchatoula. They're going to do it big. So get ready for some great prep football action. Alfab 17.
Louisiana's headed in the wrong direction, and no one is willing to do what it takes to turn our state around. I'm Gary Talbot. People call me Frog. I'm running to get things done in House District 64. Some say I'm rough around the edges. Well, I've never been afraid to stand up for what's right, whether it was fighting to protect our kids and libraries, for term limits, or for investments in roads and flood mitigation. I have never backed down. Truth is, I've never been okay with the status quo. I'm Frog Talbot, a businessman, a true conservative. Send me to Baton Rouge, and I'll fight for you.
The Player of the Game certificate will be provided courtesy of our friends at the Ponchatoula Times. The Ponchatoula Times, locally owned and operated since 1981. You can find out more about them on Facebook.
Hi, I'm Dr. Vinny Mendoza. I'm running for sheriff. I'm from Ponchatoula. I was the assistant to Inspector General of the Air Force, and I have the experience to get the job done. Especially, I know that morale is low. I want to increase the salary of the sheriff's department by 5%. And also, I have a 10-point plan that you can look at vinnymendoza.com. Thank you.
And welcome back to Alfab 17. That was Rob DeArmond. I'm with Coach Trey Willie from the Ponchatoula Greenway. Coach, week one, big game. Walker coming in here. What do you expect to see from them?
They're well coached. Coach Mahaffey, he's been around, won state championships. You know, they're a great football team. He's got them ready to play. They look great in the jamboree. So hopefully we can just match their intensity.
They got some good-looking kids, but you do as well. A lot of size, especially at the – you have a focus on defense this year. I know you're planning a balanced attack with your offense. Defense is going to be stout, especially with those two linebackers.
Our defense, we got some talented guys, Albert Smith and Jamal Sapp. But we also got some big guys up front. You know, they play great technique. They're physical. And we got, two linebackers that, they had a great week last week. And our secondary is a little bit more experienced than last year. You know, I'm happy with where they at right now, And just hopefully they can perform and play with great effort tonight.
Well, we always know a Trey Willie team is going to be competitive and they're going to fight to the bitter end. So I expect nothing different tonight. Coach, do you have any key injuries going into tonight?
Oh, we're healthy right now. So, knock on wood, thank the man upstairs. We're healthy right now. So,
God bless. So last year went to Walker, didn't really turn out in Greenway's favor. Tonight in the swamp, how big is that home field advantage?
Oh, we have great fans. So, the fans will be here. They're honoring our state championship basketball team. So, I think, the guys are going to be out here. It's going to be loud. It helps us out a lot. Our guys just got to play. They got to come out and play with effort. I told them that in the weight room. Play with effort and play with attitude, and we're gonna have a pretty good game.
There were some area games played last night, and we ran into a lot of cramping due to the heat and everything. Have you and your coaches addressed that this week?
Yeah, we tell them start drinking, fluids on Monday, and then we give them extra fluids on Wednesday. Gave them extra fluids at PE today, so they drank enough, fluids. So hopefully we got the Pedialyte and all that good stuff out for them, and hopefully it feels good right now. You got a little breeze, so hopefully they can perform.
Well, we're gonna see an exciting game, and hopefully the Green Wave will come out on top, and hopefully they come out on top without any injuries, Coach.
Thank you.
Best of luck tonight, Coach. We'll see you soon. That was Coach Trey Willie, Ponchatoula Green Wave. You are watching Alfab 17's coverage of local prep football.
TSC Logistics. Getting your freight moving toward its destination is as simple as a phone call. 225 225- 248-1573. They're at 111 Founders Drive in Baton Rouge. You can find out more about them at tsclogistics.com.
I'm Ponchatoula Police Chief Reed Larrison, and on behalf of myself and our department, we would like to wish our Ponchatoula High football team some great success this year. Good luck to you. We look forward to supporting you. We pray that you have a successful season and that none of our athletes experience any significant injuries. To our seniors, those younger classmen are looking up to you. Please provide them with the leadership. Continue to push yourself to be the best that you can be, and go get us that state championship. Good luck, God bless, and go Greenway.
And we're back. Me and Mr. DeArmond, we are in the press box now. Thank goodness, because it is hot down there, Rob.
I've lost a lot of body weight just traveling back and forth up and down the stairs doing interviews, and I don't know how much I've lost, but it'll be an interesting story to find out.
Look at the bright side. We're not in Covington.
That's true. That's a nice trek, a nice walk. I got locked in there after a track meet one time.
Yeah.
That was not fun. I got lucky enough to have the baseball team practicing on the field next door, and one of the guys was able to come get a key and get me out.
I would hate to run stadiums at Covington Field. Anyway, you are listening to Alpha F-17's coverage of local prep football tonight. Ponchatoula Green Wave and the Walker Wildcats. Rob, you're very familiar with the Wildcats. Tell me a little bit about them.
Got a nice 16-0 win over Denham Springs last week in the Denham Springs Jamboree. They put together a 16-play, 80-yard drive to start that march there to get them going. Converted on, I believe, 3 third-and-ones, and they also got a penalty on a second short to keep that drive going. Got a good mix of the run game and the pass game just to kind of get things going for them. And for them right now, and I think for everybody right now, it's just trying to get confidence in what you're doing and trying to figure it out. And last week, at least I know it's a jamboree, but at least gives you confidence moving forward with what you're doing.
You said a mouthful. Ponchatoula dropping their jamboree to St. Charles Catholic. Coach Taylor Cochran, his alma mater. Of course, St. Charles Catholic's always strong.
Exactly.
But you can only take so much away from jamborees. If you look at, Hammond had the big win against A-Meet last night. If you were to judge them by their jamboree against Live Oak, you would say, oh, my goodness, they're in trouble. But coaches try different things. It's only one live-action quarter. Coaches usually hold out kids that have a nick here or there. You don't want to risk them in a jamboree.
Exactly.
So, it shows you a little, but it doesn't show you the whole picture. And as you see, Ponchatoula is coming out of the gates. Got a capacity crowd here in the swamp. They played the national anthem. The cheerleaders, the wavettes, the flag corps, everybody's ready to go. We've been waiting for this since last November, Rob.
Basketball team got championship rings too at Ponchatoula too.
That kind of held them over, didn't it?
Yeah, but that's one of those things that you're happy to see for the program there. And
a lot of great things going on here. As you see, the captains go out for Ponchatoula. Is going to be number one, Albert Smith. Number eight is Jamal Sapp. Three is Bishop Davis. Watch him, folks. And big number 79, Travis Brumfield, another senior there out for the coin flip. Ponchatoula, it's a Trey Willie coach team. They're going to give you everything they got. The talent is usually there. So we're anticipating to see just how good this Green Wave team is and what that 6-5-A district is in store for.
This is one of those tests that when you get in the early season, you got two 5A teams playing in two tough districts. This is going to be, a testing board for both of these teams just to kind of see where you're at right off the bat and see how you match up against another 5A team, which is when you can do that early in the season, it kind of gives you a little – it's a litmus test. I mean, let's face
Without
it.
Without a doubt.
You just kind of find out where you are and what you can build on and what you need to work on, which is – it's early in the season, but you get something to look at on film from everybody.
Ponchatoula has won the toss and elected to defer to the second half. So these Walker Wildcats out of that new 5A district where they split up that old 4-5A, coached by Coach Chad Mahaffey, who you know quite well.
Right.
7-5 last year. 2-3 in district. Now, I don't know if it's going to be a big factor or anything, but Walker did not have a good road record last year, going only 1-5 on the road. So that may bode well for Ponchatoula being at home here in the Swamp.
Right. The other part here is I talked to Coach Mahaffey about that playoff loss that they had. Had a chance to win it, kick a field goal, missed the field goal, wound up losing. And he said, we've got a thing for our kids, and we just wanted to totally buy into what we're doing. He said, either you're in or you're out. And he said, for the most part, we've gotten that buy-in from the kids. And if you've watched them at all during the practice and everything, you can see there's kind of a little pep in their step. And some of the younger kids, they got a good mix of young kids and veterans. And some of those younger kids at some of those skill positions, you can see them kind of getting confidence as they go. So it's going to be interesting to see how that translates to game-type conditions, because sometimes things can start to change once the lights come on.
Sounds like two very similar head coaches here going at it, bringing the passion and the fire, and that translates to the kids. Ladies and gentlemen, this inter-parish matchup between the Cats and the Waves is made possible by Vinny Mendoza, candidate for Tensville Parish Sheriff, Gary Frog Talbert, candidate for State Rep, District 64, the Livingston Parish News, your community news source since 1898. Rob's been around that long. Ponchatoula Chief of Police, Mr. Bree Larrison, the Ponchatoula Times, and TSC Logistics. And boogity boogity, we're about to get going here, Rob, as we set up for kickoff. That's number 81. That is Titus Showers, 5'7", junior, is addressing the football. We're about to get underway, folks. Ponchatoula in their patent forest green, Walker in white. And there's the kick. Return is all the way out to the 40-yard line. We'll get a number on that young man. That is number 26. 26, Evan King on the return. And Chad Mangossing, sophomore, on the tackle. First and 10, Wildcats. Ball spotted at their own 41-yard line with the sun right in her face. All right,
Rob? Sun is dropping.
But I tell you what, they have this field looking really good.
It looks great. It really does.
Snap is back. Little screen pass that went nowhere. Gobbled up by that guy, Albert Smith, starting linebacker. I tell you, Rob, these linebackers from Ponchatoula, Smith and Sapp, both of them running 6'2", 220.
When I talked to Coach Mahaffey earlier in the week, when you start looking at it and you say, hey, you know, what are you looking at here as far as the defense? And when he spouts off about six or seven numbers, you know that emphasis is on that defensive front, those linebackers, and even some guys in the secondary. It's a top-to-bottom, a really stout defense.
Troy Silv in the gun, taking it himself, trying the right side of that Ponchatoula defense. Didn't quite get back to the original line of scrimmage. The screen pass lost about 2 yards, and it looks like they're going to give him four. Wow, that is a really good spot. Credit Robinson on the tackle. Third down, call it 8 for the Cats. Silv in the gun, calls for the football. Another screen pass. Trying to set it up for his running back. That's number 22, Clyde McClendon, who I believe has a Ponchatoula connection, if I'm not wrong. Nevertheless, pass is incomplete, and that brings up fourth down for Walker in a punting situation. That's number 39, Preston Hill, in for the punt duties
for
Walker.
More pressure from the defense there.
Back deep is Keith White, number 21, a sophomore. So first series, 3-out. That's exactly what Coach Willie was looking for. Snaps back. Punt is away. And McClendon called for a fair catch. White. I got them all back. That is McClendon. So you've been listening to and enjoying AlFab 17's coverage of local prep high school football.
Hi, I'm Dr. Vinny Mendoza. I'm from Ponchatoula, and I'm running for sheriff. I was the assistant to the Inspector General of the Air Force, and I have the experience. But the main reason why I'm running for sheriff is because I want to increase the pay of the sheriff's department. And you can look at my 10-point plan at VinnyMendoza.com.
TSC Logistics. Getting your freight moving toward its destination is as simple as a phone call. 225-248-1573. They're at 111 Founders Drive in Baton Rouge. You can find out more about them at tsclogistics.com.
Louisiana's headed in the wrong direction, and no one is willing to do what it takes to turn our state around. I'm Gary Talbot. People call me Frog. I'm running to get things done in House District 64. Some say I'm rough around the edges. Well, I've never been afraid to stand up for what's right, whether it was fighting to protect our kids and libraries, for term limits, or for investments in roads and flood mitigation. I have never backed down. Truth is, I've never been okay with the status quo. I'm Frog Talbot, a businessman, a true conservative. Send me to Baton Rouge and I'll fight for you.
And welcome back, and there's the first snap. That is Bishop handing the football off. Bishop Davis, number 3, taking the snaps. He is the Swiss Army knife of this Ponchatoula football team. They're going to line him up in a lot of different places, but if I had to guess, they're going to keep him where he's most effective.
Nice run right up the middle. You get 4 yards on the first down. Kind of helps you out there with your offense.
Trying to catch that number in the backfield with him. Bishop hands the ball off. That's number 2. That is Andrew Cangelosi. 5'9", 185-pound junior running back. Picks up a couple. As the sun blares right into our camera. So this is going to bring up third down in about 3.
Looks like it. Manageable. Very manageable play here.
Bishop in the gun. Hands the ball off. I believe that's Cangelosi again. Straight ahead. I think he's just short. It's going to depend on the spot. It's going to be close.
If he's standing right on the yard line and gets it, if it's a tan off.
Yeah, they signal first down. Cangelosi picks up the first down. Nothing fancy from this Green Wave offense. Coach Willie was quoted in the Daily Stars talking about how he wanted to do a balanced attack this year. You're going to see a good run, good mix of run and pass. Right now we've seen 3 straight running plays. Make it 4. And that run is by number 14, C.J. Brazil. Tackle made by Preston Hill for Walker. Picks up good 6-yard gain there. Yeah, good run.
That helps you out in your playbook.
Well, you'll take that on first down all day long. And as long as they keep doing that, Coach Will's going to keep running football. And there he goes again. Plowing ahead. That's 14 again. That's Brazil. Reese Dodd on the tackle for the Cats, and it's going to bring up a 3rd and about 1. They need to get right to the 45-yard line, Rob.
Right, exactly, right to the 45. Not doing anything fancy right now, just run it right at them.
And I believe this is playing in Coach Willie's playbook quite well right now. Another handoff. That is going to pick up the first down. Brazil again. And Ponchatoula moving the football here. 7:58 to go here in the first quarter. We're just underway. Be really great when that sun gets behind those pine trees back there. 1st and 10, Ponchatoula at their own 47-yard line. Now, that's someone new in the backfield. That looks like Wyatt Bennett. Oh, that's 15.
That's 15.
That's Brady Easley. Goes around the right side. Good yardage.
Another nice gain on first down.
Picks up another 7 yards. That gets him into Wildcat territory.
To the 47.
47-yard line. 1st and 10, Green Wave. It's Going to be Brazil off right tackle around the corner. Good yardage. First down. All the way down. See where they spot this football. He's going to be down near the 33, I think. 34-yard line. That looks about right. First and 10 wave. But I tell you, Rob, they're just going right at him. Saying, you can't stop
fancy.
This.
The last couple of plays, they've kind of taken around the end, but those first few plays getting this drive going are going right up the middle. Just saying, hey, we're coming right at you. Stop us.
Absolutely. So Bishop back in the gun, flanked by Cangelosi. Takes the snap. That's Cangelosi on the carry, straight ahead. Picks up about 3. Second and 7, Green Wave. Rob, the sun has found its home in the western sky.
That's a nice looking sky, too.
It's now Friday night in the swamp.
This drive is kind of reminiscent of the opening drive that Walker had against Denham last week. Just chewing up clock. And
I'd like to talk some more about that. Yeah.
Before you know it, you're sitting at less than 4 minutes left and a half.
Bishop keeps it himself. Look out. Look out. He's electric. He is around that right side, and he is going to – they're marking him out right about the 2-yard line, Rob.
The 2 looks like maybe the 1.
And I'm going to tell you something, folks. When number 3 has the ball in his hands, pay attention, because that kid can go at any second. So Ponchatoula knocking on the door here. 6:30 on your clock. First and goal, Green Wave. We have yet to see a pass from this Green Wave team.
Tried right up the middle.
Ball was stripped.
And a fumble. Looked like he tried to go for it. And the ball came out.
That ball was stripped by number 63. That is Noah Jasso. I didn't see the ball carry. Did you pick that up?
It looked like he was going in toward the middle. The ball kind of bounced out right into his hands. Made it look easy.
Was it Cangelosi, Bishop?
I think it was looked like.
It was probably Cangelosi. But don't want to blame that on him. But the ball was taken right out of his hands.
It looked like it came right out of his hands.
And unfortunately, the Green Wave had a nice drive. It got turned away.
To the 1.
All the way down to the 1-yard line. But that's a good sign. Now, we're 1st and 10 Wildcats from their own right inside the 15-yard line. That Silve connects on his pass. That's one of their playmakers, number 80. That's Caden Jones. Albert Smith on the tackle. We'll be saying his name a lot tonight. And the clock is winding down towards that heat and humidity timeout, and there it is. Ladies and gentlemen, you're enjoying now Fab 17's coverage of local prep high school football from the swamp.
I'm Ponchatoula Police Chief Reed Larrison, and on behalf of myself and our department, we would like to wish our Ponchatoula High football team some great success this year. Good luck to you. We look forward to supporting you. We pray that you have a successful season and that none of our athletes experience any significant injuries. To our seniors, those younger classmen are looking up to you. Please provide them with the leadership. Continue to push yourself to be the best that you can be, and go get us that state championship. Good luck, God bless, and go great.
The Player of the Game certificate will be provided courtesy of our friends at the Ponchatoula Times. The Ponchatoula Times, locally owned and operated since 1981. You can find out more about them on Facebook.
And welcome back, folks. As you see, Coach Taylor Cochran, O-line coach for Ponchatoula Green Wave. Good man, good coach, passionate about this football game. As a matter of fact, he is a St. Charles Catholic alumnus, who they played in their jamboree last week. Came up on the short end of that, but we know how jamborees are. 3rd down, 4 for the Wildcats. Silve takes the snap, looking to throw. He had a receiver. That was number 3, Jamari Evans. That was Smith and Bennett on the coverage for the Wave. 4th down for the Wildcats. Let's see what Coach Mahaffey opts to do here. Looks like he's going to punt. Sapp applying the pressure to Silve, which made him get rid of that football a little early. But the coverage was really good downfield, Rob.
That's that defense that Coach Mahappy was talking about. You start looking at a bunch of different numbers. You're feeling the heat from the front, and the back end is doing their job too.
So Walker to punt the football away. Back deep is White. And we have whistles. That's going to be another well, they got Sedalia this time. They did not get a time. That's okay. He might have wanted to back up anyway, depending on how good this kid's foot is.
That might actually help you out a little bit.
That's Preston Hill, the punter for the Wildcats. He pretty good punter, Rob?
Actually, this is there wasn't much punting in that. There wasn't much punting in that that jamboree there. So this is early looks at your special teams. Again, that's another layer that's been added to because you don't do it so much in those scrimmage contests.
White calls for a fair catch and corrals it at about the Green Wave, call it the 13-yard line, first and 10 Wave. Rob's good to be back, man. We got football. My Tornadoes had a big win last night against A-Meet, going up there and taking care of business. What a game that was. I'm not only am I impressed with Hampton High, but I was impressed with A-Meet as well. They have some great kids, a lot of talent, and even though the score doesn't reflect it, that game was 13-13 into the fourth quarter.
Right.
So, you know, Hammond got their points late. I think what happened was that they found that extra gear and were able to take care of business and got some breaks.
Signs of growth from Hammond, maybe.
Now, is this Bishop? That is Bishop.
Yes.
Taking the ball and look out. Look out. He's to the 40, to the 50. Making a move. That might be a face mask if they saw it. And there it is. Well, there's something on the back end back there.
On the back end. Let's see what's going on.
There was a face mask on Davis right here in front of us at about the 48-yard line of Walker. This penalty came from the backside. I don't think he saw that face mask. I think this is a block in the back.
That's what it might look like here. Let's see how this thing pans out.
But, again, you see how electric Bishop Davis is. And there it is, blocking the back. That's unfortunate. Because it wasn't necessary.
Right. He's a good 10 yards ahead of that block.
And you can tell by Coach Willie's body language, he's not happy about that at all. But it was a good call. So that gives Ponchatoula the ball at their own 37-yard line, first and 10. 4 minutes to go here in the first quarter from the Swamp. I have no idea. Our crowd has no idea what I'm talking about. That's okay. Bishop Davis takes the snap and takes it himself around the right side. Look out, and he may go. Nope. And there's another flag coming in. I hope that's not a block. Because, again, Davis got loose. Tyler Galladora corralled him out there. But I think this is something that's a holding or a block in the back over there. Davis got the ball down to about the 35-yard line of Walker. And they're walking backwards. So this is probably going to go against the Green Wave. It's some kind of illegal block or holding. Here's the call. And there's the hold. Holding off the edge right there. Yeah, that holding on the edge kind of makes it easy for your ball carrier.
But you can also see how dynamic the quarterback is here.
No doubt.
Nothing fancy, just I'm going to take it, and here we go. We're rolling.
I tell you, he took over the second half of the Hammond-Ponchatoula game last year, and Hammond had no answer. There's a rare one, Tommy just pointed out. First and 4.
That's a good point there, Tommy.
You don't call that too often. So, do you have to guess who's going to try to – make this play right here? And as a result, because I said that, he gives it to CJ Brazil, who plows ahead for about a yard. Chad Mangossing on the tackle. Second down, we'll call it 3.
Second and 3. Once again, one you don't see very often.
Yeah. But very manageable for the Green Wave.
Absolutely.
Bishop in the gun, flanked by Brazil. Takes the snap, gives it off to Brazil. Brazil straight ahead. He's going to be close to that first down. I think he's going to get the spot. And they're going to move those sticks. That's going to be a first down green wave at their own, call it the 47-yard line. And green wave is moving again. Now, on the last drive, Rob, they moved very methodically. They moved it right down the field. They shoved it right down Walker's throat. They got to the 1 yard line and had the mishap.
We have yet to see a pass from Ponchatoula in this game.
You are correct, sir. And why put it in the air if you can do that?
It is being absolutely effective on the ground. Why stray from it right now?
I'll run the ball all night. You give me 4 yards of play.
As soon as we say
here that. Here we say that. And he had a man, and that's going to be intercepted. That is by number 24, Manzi Berry. That's the kid that had the strip on the fumble. Now, there's a flag. That's blocking the back. That's coming back. Nevertheless, it is another turnover, and I'll stand corrected. That interception is by number 29, Jalen Jackson. Is that correct? Tyler Rainey, I'm sorry. Tyler Rainey. Davis had I've got my things mixed up. Anyway, Davis had 15 easily, who had a step, but he kind of overthrew it, and it allowed the defender to pick that pass off and brings it all the way back across midfield. But after the penalty, they're going to spot this at the Walker 47-yard line, first and 10. Your score is 0-0. A little over 2 minutes to go here in the first quarter. I'm Matt Greer, joined by Mr. Rob DeArmond from the Livingston Times. And
Livingston Parish News.
Livingston Parish News, I'm sorry. And we got Mr. Tommy Hazelwood up top doing the filming for you. Straight ahead was McClendon for about five. 23 on the tackle. That was Fuentes James. And that play's going nowhere. 23 is a special number here at Ponchatoula, in remembrance of Charlie Landry. Good friend of ours. And a great family, that Landry family. A staple in Ponchatoula. Always has been. Always will be. Love those people. And that young man is wearing that cherished number. Because I tell you, if you ever got to see Charlie Landry play football, he was something to see.
Indeed.
All heart.
Electric type player. Tough. Tough as nails.
And again, that's McClendon on the carry off the left side. That's going to be short. It's going to bring up a fourth down. Let's see where they're spotting this thing. Right at the Ponchatoula 45-yard line. I wouldn't be surprised if they go for this. Under a minute here to go in this first quarter from the Swamp. Decision time for Coach Mahaffey. Now, you know him better than I do, Rob. I mean, what do you think he's going to do? Looks like he's going for it.
They're going to go for it. They're in a good situation here, and just try to see what you can get.
Everyone in tight. Got his big boys in there. And there's McClendon right straight ahead, and he picked it up pretty easily. Found a crease on the right side of the wave defense and got it down to about the 40. We'll call it the 39-yard line, first and 10 Cats. Winding down, under 20 seconds to go here in the first quarter. I think we might see one more play.
Talked to Coach Mahaffey in preseason with McClendon. They're trying to get into to realize that you can get to that second level, and that's kind of, you know, instead of a 6 yard gain, try to shoot for a 10, maybe 16 yard
gain. Absolutely.
And that's what they're looking to see. There, you see it a little bit right there from them on that play.
And we got flags on this play. It's going to stop that clock. Now the clock ran all the way down, but I think they're going to put a couple seconds back on. There was a procedure on number two down here near the Ponchatoula sideline. He moved a little early. Eagle Eyes Hazelwood caught that for us. He has one. Now there it is. They got the 2 seconds back on the clock.
Put 2 seconds back on.
So first and 15, Wildcats, and they're just going to tick that off. And that is going to be the end of the first quarter. From here, in Ponchatoula at the Swamp. It's football, baby. It's fall. It's hot. I got my good buddy Rob DeYarman with me, and we're making the call. This is Alfab 17 Prep Football.
Louisiana's headed in the wrong direction, and no one is willing to do what it takes to turn our state around. I'm Gary Talbot. People call me Frog. I'm running to get things done in House District 64. Some say I'm rough around the edges. Well, I've never been afraid to stand up for what's right, whether it was fighting to protect our kids and libraries, for term limits, or for investments in roads and flood mitigation. I have never backed down. Truth is, I've never been okay with the status quo. I'm Frog Talbot, a businessman, a true conservative. Send me to Baton Rouge and I'll fight for you.
TSC Logistics, getting your freight moving toward its destination is as simple as a phone call. 225-248-1573. They're at 111 Founders Drive in Baton Rouge. You can find out more about them at tsclogistics.com.
Hi, I'm Dr. Vinny Mendoza. I'm running for sheriff. I'm from Ponchatoula. I was the assistant to the Inspector General of the Air Force, and I have the experience to get the job done. Especially, I know that morale is low. I want to increase the salary of the Sheriff's Department by 5%. And also, I have a 10-point plan that you can look at VinnyMendoza.com. Thank you.
Okay, first and 15, we're back. Wildcats into Green Wave territory. No score in this one. We've had two turnovers, both by the Green Wave. Silv pitches it out to McClendon, who gets just, looks like he's going to get just past the original line of scrimmage.
It's actually Caden Jones on that play. Caden Jones on the carry for Walker.
Caden Jones was the ball carrier. Thank you, Rob. Silv getting the play from Coach Mahaffey. And we got trips to this side of the field. Silv in the gun. That's Caden again. Straight up the middle. That's number 80. Once again, that's James on the tackle. Fuentes James wearing that number 23, senior. So he's had at least three tackles tonight already. So that brings up third down, and we'll call it about four for the Wildcats. Green Wave need another stand right here. Whistles.
What do we got?
Not sure what they held that up for. I think they were allowing Ponchatoula to make a substitution. And here we go. White hat blows it ready for play. Watch how Silv crouches way down to receive this.
I noticed that last week as I was watching.
Almost like a catcher. And there's a screen pass. Again, that's Caden James.
Jones is a receiver there. He's a running back receiver, multi-faceted player for the Wildcats.
A little screen pass. Robinson on the tackle.
Saw it last night. Sure did. Swing it game.
Fourth down, Cats. 1 yard to go. Walker will go for this. Ponchatoula stacking the box straight ahead. I don't know. I don't think he got there. Yeah, there is no gain, and Ponchatoula is stout. I'd like to call numbers. I'm sure 23 was in there somewhere. But
That was just a group. You try to take it right up the middle and see what happens there, but as I said before, trying to run right against this defensive front is a tough task.
Okay, so you're Ponchatoula. You've turned it over at the 1. You've turned it over at the 20. You still got 0 points on the board, but you're not getting beat.
Correct.
You're taking Walker's shots, and now you need to go down and get some pay dirt. Bishop in the gun with Cangelosi. There's the snap. This is Cangelosi on the carry. And he's got some room on the right side. Tackled there by
Ja'Kyron Johnson. And it looks like Coach Willie has a little stable of ponies here in the running back department, Rob.
They're spreading it out. They're using everybody right now, too.
Which, that's so valuable. It's running back by committee now. It's you don't really see those workhorse backs anymore.
Keeps you guys fresh, so yeah, there's nobody getting tired. And especially early in the season, too, you can establish some things.
Davis keeps it himself, and that's going to be a first down out to the 46-yard line. Alvion Prejean on the tackle for the Cats. So Ponchatoula's moving the football.
Right.
They just keep shooting themselves in
right.
the foot.
It's kind of this is what happened to them last week if you watched a little bit of the jamboree. Moving the ball well, just some turnovers hurt them.
Silves gives it to Cangelosi this time. He's going to pick up about two. But I tell you, that type of running is going to wear out a defense.
Yes.
When you're pounding that line like that.
No doubt. No doubt.
Something's going to shake loose soon. So there's Davis, flanked by Jacob P. And P with the football. Tries the right side. He's going to lose yardage. I believe that's 24 on the tackle, Tommy? Yeah, 88 have the initial penetration. Draven Dixon. And then Travion Thomas mopped it up.
Have not seen many negative yardage runs from the Green Wave tonight.
Third down, and we'll call it about 14 for the Wave. Let's see what the OC decides to do here. Is he going to go to the air, or is he going to let Bishop try to get some of this yardage back with his feet? Bishop will throw. Nope, there he goes. Look out. Look out. Look out. Look out. Now, he's going to be short, but this is manageable, Rob.
Perfectly, you're exactly right, Matt. Takes it right up the middle. Looks like he's going to throw right at first, but that's the mobility that you see that he's showing all night.
Bardalis on the tackle. Fourth down, we'll call it two. For the Greenies, 7:25 left to go in the first half. First half moving kind of fast. I like that.
Shush.
I know Tommy does.
Matt, you know, I shouldn't have said anything. You know what that means.
But we're having fun.
You know what that means,
Matt. Coach Willie wants to talk about this. Time out, Ponchatoula. You are enjoying Alfab 17's coverage of local prep high school football.
I'm Ponchatoula Police Chief Reed Larrison, and on behalf of myself and our department, we would like to wish our Ponchatoula High football team some great success this year. Good luck to you. We look forward to supporting you. We pray that you have a successful season and that none of our athletes experience any significant injuries. To our seniors, those younger classmen are looking up to you. Please provide them with the leadership. Continue to push yourself to be the best that you can be, and go get us that state championship. Good luck, God bless, and go Green.
The Player of the Game certificate will be provided courtesy of our friends at the Ponchatoula Times. The Ponchatoula Times, locally owned and operated since 1981. You can find out more about them on Facebook.
Fourth down, two for the Green Wave. Bishop Davis calls for the football, and he got him. He got him. That's that hard count, and that's a discipline. Rob, we saw this last night in the Hammond A-Me game. The freshman quarterback, Taryn Jones, on the hard count, got A-Me to jump at least four or five times, resulting in first downs.
That's just
going to make a coach pull his hair out.
That'll drive you nuts. That's one of those things that they teach in practice all the time, and you have to be disciplined in that situation.
First down, Green Wave. From the 41-yard line, is that Davis? Davis on the keeper gets across the 35 down to the 34, I believe. Good pickup there. Okay, they're going to give him about the 33-yard line.
The 33 there.
Under 7 minutes to go. Second down. We'll call it a long two for the Greenies. This is Brazil right up the middle, but Brazil's a big bruising back.
Again, nothing fancy here at all.
CJ Brazil. Six-foot-200 junior. He's a good-looking kid. See if they get this snap off. Rob, we're coming up on a hydration break. Bishop Davis keeps it himself, makes a move, finds a crease, and he's down. He's going to have a first down. Green Wave heading into the hydration break. That is Draven Dixon on the tackle, and that is the hydration break for the players, the coaches, and the referees, and for Tommy and Rob and I. This is Alfab 17 Prep Football. Bishop Davis is not in the game unless is that him up top? It is not.
That is not him.
That is easily taking this snap and keeping it himself. Comes around the right side, and that's nothing doing. Tackle for a loss. That is by number 6 from the Wildcats. And that is Dante Flowers. I'm sure you're familiar with that young
nice
man.
Nice pursuit there, right.
See Davis coming back in from the sideline. He probably just needs a little breather. He's such a big part of this Green Wave offense. So 5:30 to go. Second down, 15. 14.
Also about 6 there, Matt, looks like.
Player in motion. This is Brazil right up the gut. Cutting through that Wildcat defense. Tackle made there by number 42, Aiden Smith from the Wildcats. Ball spotted at the 17-yard line.
Back to the original line of scrimmage there.
And that'll be a third down for the Green Wave. Now, we saw Titus Showers as their kicker. I was not watching pregame kicks. Rob, were you watching that?
No, I was not. Run around a little bit, breaking a sweat.
You're trying to track down Coach Mahaffey over
there.
Yes,
I was.
And a bottle of water. So, big play here. I think if Ponchatoula gets down close to this, they're going to go. And the play clock was running low, and Coach Willie opted for a timeout. While we have that second to talk, I'd like to mention that this matchup between the Cats and the Wave made possible by Vinny Mendoza, candidate for Tensville Parish Sheriff. Ponchatoula Times, TSC Logistics, Gary Frog Talbert, candidate for State Representative, District 64. Livingston Parish News for a community news source since 1898. They've been around a while.
Wow, yes, sir.
Ponchatoula Police Chief, my friend, Mr. Bree Larrison. And thank you so much. We couldn't be putting this on the air for you without these fine folks. And you wouldn't get the joy of listening to me. Mr. Tommy's on top of the press box, blowing wind. Is that what you said? Oh, the wind was blowing. Oh, okay. Blowing wind. That's something different. Oh, he's a meteorologist now. We got a light gust in from the southeast, folks.
It's a big play right here.
Bishop Davis flanked by Canzalosi, and he looks to throw. Nope, he's going to pull it down and run, and he is inside the 10-yard line. They're going to give him the get all the way down to the 3. So
definitely, they had to get to the 7 for the first down.
So definitely first down.
Looks like about the – looks like they're giving them a 3 there.
3-yard line, first and goal, Wave. They got to punch it in here. I think if they can get in the end zone here and hold Walker out before half, Coach Willie will be pleased with this. That's Brazil straight ahead. Nothing doing, but he's still working.
He's still moving.
Yeah, ball came out, but I think the whistles had blown. One of the tacklers, Patrick McKenzie, was in there.
But I believe it was Jeffrey Caldwell came out with the football. Canzalosi set up behind Davis here. P in that H-back position. And that's P. Nope. They fooled me. Little counter play that Walker knew it because they made the tackle. Not much gain there. Maybe one, Rob? They got down to the two.
Looks like they gave him one on that.
Right on the 2 yard line, so that's third down goal from the two. Canzalosi coming off.
It's one thing I noticed about Ponchatoula last week. You see those ball fakes, and they're fooling everybody, even us up here.
It's pretty easy to fool me, Rob.
I wasn't going to say that.
And that's Davis straight ahead. He went under center, and I don't think he got there. Yeah, he might have got the one. So another 1 yard gain.
They needed a bigger surge out of the line there to get that ball in there. So it's a fourth and one, man. You know, at this point, you gotta go.
Even if you don't get this, you're going to have Walker pinned pretty deep, and he'd have to go 99 yards to get in.
Exactly.
So it's a no-brainer to go here. They got to get Davis loose. And he's in. There he is. They faked the dive to CJ Brazil, and Wildcats bid on it big time.
It was ball fakes. That's what I was talking about earlier.
Well, he got the linebackers to chew on it, and it opened up that left side, and Davis was able to just waltz on in. Great play. Touchdown, Green Wave. 6-0 here at the 2 minute, 1 second mark. So let's see. This is the kicker. Let's see. Is that 13, Tommy?
Yes.
13 is Jace Jackson. There's a time. Walker calls timeout. We'll take it with him. This is Alfab 17's coverage of local prep football.
Hi, I'm Dr. Vinny Mendoza. I'm from Ponchatoula, and I'm running for sheriff. I was the assistant to the Inspector General of the Air Force, and I have the experience. But the main reason why I'm running for sheriff is because I want to increase the pay of the sheriff's department. And you can look at my 10-point plan at vinnymendoza.com.
TSC Logistics. Getting your freight moving toward its destination is as simple as a phone call. 225-248-1573. They're at 111 Founders Drive in Baton Rouge. You can find out more about them at tsclogistics.com.
Louisiana's headed in the wrong direction, and no one is willing to do what it takes to turn our state around. I'm Gary Talbot. People call me Frog. I'm running to get things done in House District 64. Some say I'm rough around the edges. Well, I've never been afraid to stand up for what's right, whether it was fighting to protect our kids and libraries, for term limits, or for investments in roads and flood mitigation. I have never backed down. Truth is, I've never been okay with the status quo. I'm Frog Talbot, a businessman, a true conservative. Send me to Baton Rouge and I'll fight for you.
And welcome back. And here we are for the point after touchdown from the Green Wave.
This is Thomas.
Doing the deep snapping is Sean
Tommy's favorite play, Pursuer? The swinging game.
I don't want to murder that.
It's Tommy's favorite play, the swinging game.
13 is the holder. And that good kick is up and good. What's the number on that kicker, Tommy? Is that 99?
80.
It's got to be 89.
89, he's right there.
Ethan Larcella, senior kicker. So Titus Showers must handle the kickoffs for Ponchatoula, and Larcella does the PATs and field goals. Nonetheless, it's 7-0, Green Wave, much to the pleasure of the local faithful here in the swamp. So finally, Ponchatoula is able to crack the scoreboard. They penetrated into Wildcat territory twice and came away with nothing. They finally were able to get in there.
Against, to be honest, Walker's fortunate to be only down 7-0.
Sticking to that ground game, it's been super effective. Really no reason to pass the ball right now.
Now, Ponchatoula went to Walker last year. Were you at that game, Rob?
Yes. Yes, I was.
Kind of came up on the short end of that one, 33-13. So Ponchatoula looking for a little redemption this year here in the Swamp.
From what I remember, lots of scoring in that game.
And that is Showers doing the kickoff. I'm hearing whistles. This play is dead. I think we had a procedure on the kicking team. So they'll back this up 5 yards, and we'll do it again. Ponchatoula 5-6 last year, 3-4 in district. Went to the first round of playoffs, had to go all the way to Benton, and came up on the wrong end of that. But they did post a 4-2 home record here at Ponchatoula.
Always good for anybody to play at home. Always get good crowds here at Ponchatoula. You see it again tonight.
I believe it was Benton that eventually knocked out Denham Springs. Is that correct? I could be wrong about that. So here's Showers with the kick. That ball is heading out of bounds, and that's going to be a flag.
Another flag there.
They change these rules so often. Let's see. Are they going to spot this at the 35? Is that what they do? Wildcat football. We are under 2 minutes to go till halftime. I think they have that option to kick them and kick it again if they prefer. So I think they could take it at the 35 for the spot, or they can make them kick. And with the way this is going, if I'm Walker, I'm making them kick again as well. Eighteen seniors on this Ponchatoula Green Wave team, Rob. 7 returning starters. 18 seniors. That's a good many.
That's pretty good. That's a good foundation to build your team.
Well, and the thing about Ponchatoula is the cupboard's never empty. You're going to have players every year. Ties to kick off again. This one is squibbed right down the middle. That's Jaden Bardalis on the return, getting it almost out to midfield. Tackle there by 50, Brennan Bishop, junior linebacker.
Jaden Bardalis has a little speed. He took a silver medal at the AAU Junior Olympics over the summer.
Good stuff. 1st and 10 Cats from their own 45-yard line. Ponchatoula would like to go into halftime with this score or better. Seal to throw. Ball almost intercepted by Sapp.
I thought he had it.
He had his sights on it, went and put his hands to his helmet. 2nd down 10 for Walker. Silv hands it off straight away. This is McClendon on the carry. Robinson on the tackle. Looks like no gain. They'll give him a yard. That's a pretty good spot.
It looks like he got two there.
But this Ponchatoula defense is delivering what Coach Willie asked for to this point. Silv in that crouch position to receive the football. Looks like Johnny Bench back there.
That looks like something they maybe figured out in practice. It's like, okay, this is what I'm going to have to do to get this snap out and make that adjustment.
Now, that was a very athletic play over here on this sideline by number three, Jamari Evans. Unfortunately for him, that he came down out of bounds, which will bring up a fourth down for the Cats. Minute 10 to go with the clock stopped, and Coach Mahaffey is going to punt. Keith White, once again, back to receive this punt from Preston Hill, the punter for the Wildcats. Pretty good opportunity for Greenway to try to go down and get some more points before halftime, Rob.
Missed opportunity there by Walker. They obviously needed some points in that situation.
Punt is away. White lets it bounce. And that was kind of dangerous. That ball bounced off a Wildcat, and then a Greeny picked it up. 45.
That's one of those balls where you're trying to get out the way. You think,
fire,
the,
move.
The,
yeah, right.
Get a little talking to from the coach down there.
45, Skylar Rice comes up with it. And you see Coach Willie letting him know about it right now. You get away from that.
That is a lesson learned.
And as I'm reminded by our eyes in the sky, Ponchatoula will receive the second half kickoff. So this is really playing into their favor here.
Exactly.
And that brisk breeze at their back Tommy keeps talking about. So let's see how aggressive Coach Willie wants to get. Davis looked to go to the air, pulls it down, and shoestring tackle there. He's only going to pick up a couple. Clock continues to run under a minute. Once again, Thomas on the tackle. Ponchatoula not getting in a big hurry here, Rob.
No, this is something that they've got the lead and the ball. You're heading to halftime. No need to rush things.
I think they're just going to keep running their offense, and if something pops loose, so be it. But you see Walker with three DBs back around midfield, and he hands the ball off. I believe that's P. P right up the middle, picks up good yardage, but this may take us to halftime because we're under 10 seconds, and I see Ponchatoula starting to head to the locker room, and that's going to do it. So, interesting first half, a couple of turnovers, which didn't hurt Ponchatoula, other than the fact that they didn't put points on the board when they should have. We'll see how that plays out in the game to come. That being said, we are at halftime here in the Swamp. Your score, Green Wave 7, Walker Wildcats 0. We'll take a break, and you're enjoying Alfab 17's coverage of local prep football. I'm Matt Greer along with Rob DeArmond and the Eyes in the Sky, Tommy Hazelwood. Thanks for being with us.
TSC Logistics. Getting your freight moving toward its destination is as simple as a phone call. 225-248-1573. They're at 111 Founders Drive in Baton Rouge. You can find out more about them at tsclogistics.com.
The Player of the Game certificate will be provided courtesy of our friends at the Ponchatoula Times. The Ponchatoula Times, locally owned and operated since 1981. You can find out more about them on Facebook.
And we're back from halftime here at the Swamp. Your score, Ponchatoula 7, Wildcats 0. Wildcats from Walker. I'm here with my good friend, Mr. Rob DeArmond from Livingston Parish News.
Correct.
Been around since 1898.
I got it all, man.
I got to get in good with your editor. So the Zebras have their meeting at midfield, and we'll be getting underway here shortly. Tommy pointed out, not going to take us a whole long heap of time to do the scoring recap. It is 7-0 Green Wave. Ponchatoula got the ball, drove down to about the 1-yard line, fumbled. Walker was not able to do anything with that. Ponchatoula got the ball again, drove to about the 20 and threw an interception. Again, Walker was turned away. And then finally, in the second quarter, Ponchatoula was able to put a semblance of a drive together and punch one in from about 2 yards out. And there's your score, 7-0 Greens.
So on a fourth down play as well, it's Bishop Davis going in for the touchdown. That interception for Ponchatoula is the only pass attempt for them in the game.
That is an interesting stat. One pass, one pick.
Just shows you how effective the run game has been for them tonight.
All right, so we're getting set to go here. Now, I don't know if that's the kicker, Rob, for Walker. That is a big kicker.
He's a defensive lineman as well.
92, that is Sam Ponce, and he's a hoss. Bennett and Jackson back to receive this Wildcat kick, and it's a short one.
Onside kick.
Onside kick, and it looks like Walker has the football. I didn't see which player came out of there with it. I'm looking at my roster, and I didn't actually see. Did he squib kick? It was an intentional onside?
Looked like just a short kick, onside kick, just to try to get some momentum going.
You see a lot of these teams going to that little pooch kick. They try to find that no man's land.
Right. Right.
You're seeing more of that instead of the generic onside.
Albany did the same thing last night to start off the game with Independence and recovered it, and then they scored in the first play of the game. So, obviously, Walker's hoping for the same type of result here. I don't know if they score in the first play, but, it gives you some momentum regardless.
So, Wildcats take away a possession from the Green Wave, and they set up shop in Green Wave territory at their 45. This is McClendon plowing ahead. He's going to pick up 10 and a first down.
Those are the types of runs that they're looking for from McClendon. Talk to Coach Mahaffey, like I mentioned before. They want to see him get to the second level, and that's what you saw right there.
You sure did. And they're going to mark him just a yard short.
Yeah, sure.
It sure did look like he got across that 35-yard line for first down. Nevertheless, it's second down, one Cats. Silve gets the football straight ahead and fighting. I don't know if he got there because there is a host of greenies that met him rudely.
He had a surge right there. If they spot him right there where that official was standing on the 35, that would give him the first down. And there go the chains. They're moving. He got it.
They gave him forward progress. Big 99, Jacoby Berry, 6'2", 335 junior in on that. It was just enough. First down, Cats. At the Tula 35, Silve rolls out to his left. He's going to put one in the end zone, and that is going to be a – did he drop it? No, that is a touchdown.
Touchdown. Got a touchdown. Jamari Evans right
Beautiful
there.
Beautiful pitch touchdown. And catch from Silve to Jamari Evans. That is a 35-yard touchdown by the Cats, and they are right back in this thing, pending the PAT. Now, does that big defensive lineman do the PATs as well?
Is he coming out?
Looks like that doesn't look like him. Let's see if we can get a number on that young man. Oh, that is him.
So Sam is back out there to kick it.
Yeah, that's him. Sam Ponce for PAT, trying to tie this thing up. And I think we have movement.
Looked like we had a movement on the right side of the line there.
That's going to back them up 5, I believe. Well, they're not. It's against Ponchatoula.
Oh, it's Ponchatoula.
So that'll be half the distance. Do they go for 2? I tell you, with Big McClendon back there, I'd be tempted to do that. But it looks like Ponce is going to stay in and attempt this little closer PAT. And that kick is up,
and
it's good, and that ties your score at 7. Here from the Swamp, 11:02 left to go. This is Alfab 17 Local Prep Football.
Louisiana's headed in the wrong direction, and no one is willing to do what it takes to turn our state around. I'm Gary Talbot. People call me Frog. I'm running to get things done in House District 64. Some say I'm rough around the edges. Well, I've never been afraid to stand up for what's right, whether it was fighting to protect our kids and libraries, for term limits, or for investments in roads and flood mitigation. I have never backed down. Truth is, I've never been okay with the status quo. I'm Frog Talbot, a a businessman, a true conservative. Send me to Baton Rouge, and I'll fight for you.
Welcome back, and there is Mr. Punch, who was intricate in this score. Rob, he had the onside kick. I'm sorry, I'm chewing on a crackling here. It's delicious. Yeah, the onside kick set him up, and then Silv throws the 35-yard touchdown pass to tie this score up. And this one he kicks away. And that's going to be number five. That's Wyatt Bennett.
Got a flag that's
flags down.
Back.
Tyler Covington on the tackle for the Wildcats. Now, Wyatt Bennett was our AlFab 17 player of the game last week. It's the Butch Lee Memorial Award. Are you familiar with Butch? Butch?
I remember Butch. Yes.
I tell you, he was one heck of a man, and we miss him dearly. So we dedicate this award to him. And Mr. Bennett won that last week. And tonight, you and I will be selecting a player of the game. And for our purposes, Walker's, they're kind of out of our viewing area. So probably win, lose, or draw, we're going to pick a greenie here. And that player getting the Butch Lee Memorial Award will get a seafood platter gift certificate from Hookies.
Nothing wrong with that at all.
I'm going to have to try this place. Sounds really good. Bishop Davis, once again, in the gun. Hands the ball straight ahead. Brazil,
14
with the carry. Looks to pick up about three. Setting up second down and seven. Green Wave at their own 17-yard line. Looks like, looking across the way, it looks like Walker traveled very well. Their side is
sure
packed.
Sure did.
And you know what you get on this side of the field, because Ponchatoula is going to bring it every game. End around, that's number six. That's Corey Jackson. Another one of those playmakers. Junior. Now, I'm curious, there was a Corey Jackson that played linebacker for us here, number 52, back 84 through 88. I wonder if that's his son or a relative or nephew or something. I'll give Corey a buzz and find out.
That is possible.
Did I say us? I said us. I did. Oh, my players are going to be so mad at me. Third down, three for the Wave. And we got timeout on the field. And that's going to be timeout Ponchatoula. This is AlFab 17, local prep football.
Hi, I'm Dr. Benny Mendoza. I'm from Ponchatoula, and I'm running for sheriff. I was the assistant to the Inspector General of the Air Force, and I have the experience. But the main reason why I'm running for sheriff is because I want to increase the pay of the sheriff's department. And you can look at my 10-point plan at VinnyMendoza.com.
Third down, three, Green Wave. Davis calling for the football. Going to keep it himself, find that crease, and he's going to be, he's just short. He picked up about two. And I'm pretty sure that's going to bring up a fourth down. And are they giving him this? Are my eyes that bad?
That looked like a massive cramp.
Yeah,
that just dropped.
Yeah, I tell you, we had cramp issues last night in the Amede Hammond game. Both sides of the field, seemed like every play they were going down. Roger Gill was doing the radio broadcast. He said it was the longest third quarter in the history of his life. But hopefully that's all that is from that young man from Walker, that it's just a cramp. And we'll take a break. This is AlFab 17. Okay, and they get that young man up. Looks like that was Dante Flowers that was cramping up there. Good to see him come off the field. Just a reminder, folks, AlFab 17 has got some games coming up next week. Next Thursday, I am with Wes Younger in Ameet. Oh, it's his broadcast debut. I didn't know that. But I'm glad to be having him with me. That's Amit LaRonja next Thursday. I believe this is Cangelosi straight ahead.
Straight ahead.
So they did give him that first down. Evan King on the tackle for the Wildcats picks up, we'll call it three, Rob.
Again,
maybe two. My eyes are bad,
again,
man.
Nothing here. Looks like maybe three there.
Where's Butch Lee when you need him? Because he can spot that. We'll call it second and seven for the Green Wave. Davis in the gun. Fakes the handoff to Cancelosa. Keeps himself. Comes around 40. 45, 50. He's down to about the 30-yard line. Wildcats able to just ball him up. And there's a late flag.
Looks like a late flag there, too.
I think there was a late shove by Wildcat on Davis. That's going to tack 15 more onto this, which is going to set him up down at the 15-yard line. First and 10, Green Wave. That is a huge play for the Green Wave.
Once again, you see on that play, we talked about the ball fakes early. You see that fake, they kind of bite on it, and then he comes around the right side. Pretty much how you want to draw it up there.
He is fun to watch, folks. And if you're a Ponchatoula fan, you're loving that. Personal foul, Wildcats, and that is first down. They're going to move this ball all the way down to the 15-yard line, where Ponchatoula will set up shop first and 10. And inside the red zone, need to come away with points in a tie ball game. 8:23 left to go here. Heading towards the north end zone. Davis in the gun, been there all night. Looks to throw, and it's not there, and he tucks it and picks up a few yards. And I think that's the directive from the coaching staff on Davis, that if it's there, turn it loose. If not, tuck it and go.
Great decision. He reads it. He sees what's happening and takes it out of bounds. You got another play there, so nothing lost.
It's a great luxury to have that you don't have a receiver shake loose, and you got a guy with Davis's wheels that can get positive yards for you. So that is second down. We'll call it eight. Picked up two on the play. Davis calls for the football. Keeps it himself, straight ahead. He's going to pick up a couple more. These are hard, tough yards. The interiors of these defenses are rugged, Rob.
Exactly. You don't want to say mirror images, but the same body types and the same style of players on the front line, which makes it tough for both of these teams to get anything on the inside.
Yes, sir. Big, strong, gutsy kids. And you and I both know the game's won in those trenches.
Absolutely.
Those unsung heroes down in there. Davis with Cangelosi.
And got a little movement there.
He got him. I believe that's going to be a 5-yard penalty. It won't be enough for a first down. I think it was a couple of them come across.
Yeah, it looked like a pair of guys kind of moved. It looked like both of your ends kind of moved there.
Again, that's first game of the year. We saw this last night. That hard count, it's a discipline. That's why we practice it. We run sprints, and if you jump on the count, the sprint don't count. Davis pitches out to Cangelosi around the right side. He's down to about the 6-yard line. They're going to stack him up there.
Nice pursuit by the defense to stand him up and kind of stop the play.
Russ and Flowers on the tackle. Ball came out, but I think he was blown dead. Now, this is interesting. Fourth and Rob will call it one. And as Tommy points out, this is exact down and distance that they scored on last time.
Fourth
pretty much, but it was from the 2-yard line. Mr. Davis waiting for the football. Keeps it. Follows Cangelosi. I think he's going to have the first. He's right at the 5, which is where the stick
That's
is.
That's exactly where he had to get the first down. And if they give them a spot where they're standing right now, there it is.
And there it is. First and goal, Green Wave from the 5. And you can hear the Ponchatoula faithful applauding that. Anticipating a Green Wave score here. Davis calls for the football. Brazil takes the ball straight ahead. He's plowing. He's churning. Down to about the 2. We might get one more play in here before the hydration timeout at the 6-minute mark.
You got a little difference between the play clock and the...
And we have an injury on the field that could be another cramp. Let's hope that's all that is. This is Alfab 17's coverage of local prep football.
I'm Ponchatoula Police Chief Reed Larrison, and on behalf of myself and our department, we would like to wish our Ponchatoula High football team some great success this year. Good luck to you. We look forward to supporting you. We pray that you have a successful season and that none of our athletes experience any significant injuries. To our seniors, those younger classmen are looking up to you. Please provide them with the leadership. Continue to push yourself to be the best that you can be, and go get us that state championship. Good luck, God bless, and go Greenway.
And that's Mr. CJ Brazil getting an applause from the crowd. A little dinged up. They were looking at that leg. It wasn't a cramp. Hopefully it's nothing serious, because Ponchatoula could ill afford to lose that young man. So Cangelosi into the game. 6 minutes, 16 seconds here in this third quarter, 16 seconds away from the hydration timeout, and running. Cangelosi set up behind Davis. He gets the football. Cangelosi to the goal line. Is he in? They're marking him at the 1 yard line, and we are going to take a hydration timeout, but we're also going to take this opportunity to mention our underwriters for tonight. This game with the Wildcats and the Waves made possible by Mr. Vinny Mendoza, candidate for Tanspa Parish Sheriff; Gary Frog Talbert, candidate for State Rep, District 64. That's a cool name. I think people will vote for that just because he's got a cool name. The Livingston Parish News, your community news source since 1898. That's where Mr. Rob DeArmond works.
That is correct, my employer.
My good friend, the Chief of Police here in Ponchatoula, Mr. Bree Larrison, the Ponchatoula Times, and TSC Logistics. And as we're speaking of that, Mr. Steve Easterling works there at TSC, and he'll be doing the game with you, Rob, next Friday at Denham Springs when they take on Glen Oaks.
Actually, I think that's a Thursday game.
It is. Did I say Friday?
You said Friday. That's okay.
Hey, it's my first game, too.
That's okay, though. I'm looking forward to it.
I can't let Tommy do all the screw-ups. I got to do something wrong. And while we have a quick second, I'm looking down to my right. I tell you, they have treated us so well here at Ponchatoula. Mr. Jeremy Harper has really laid out the carpet for you, Rob.
Coach Harper has done a great job. A lot of people don't realize what goes into making these things happen, and he's made a point to make us comfortable, make sure we're comfortable here, and we are, and we appreciate it, Coach Harper and Ponchatoula High School.
Third and goal from the 1. Cangelosi to the goal line. No signal. They're marking him down. 4th and 1. Wow. Big defense from the Wildcats. Yeah,
we said it earlier. It's tough to run up the middle on either one of these defenses, and here you go. You got another 4th and goal situation.
Me personally, I get Davis in space somewhere and just let him run. And they tried to push straight ahead, and I think he's going to get there. There it is, the signal. That is a touchdown. Bishop Davis just followed his O-line and just leaned on him, and those big boys got the push they needed to get it across the goal line. As they're unpeeling these bodies, people are starting to cramp.
We got multiple players down that looks like cramps.
Yep. When you see them stretching their legs out like that, folks, and that's Davis over here on the sideline. They're stretching out his cramp. And the Wildcats have a defensive lineman down right at the goal line with cramps as well. But back to Jeremy Harbor. He's my friend. I love Jeremy Harper.
Jeremy for a long time. I think we've kind of grown up in the business together, him coaching me, writing, and And our kids are the same age. They've grown up playing ball together.
We have a blast with him on Under the Hood with Roger.
It's great stuff. Like I told you, when you get together, it's like talking with friends. Makes it real easy.
Yes. Now, look, he's Ponchatoula through and through now. I mean, he is passionate about these programs here at Ponchatoula High School.
Yes.
But he is an ally and a friend, and I'm glad to know him and glad that he's my friend.
And the help we got, I mean, I was texting you guys back and forth all day. Okay, here's what Jeremy's got for us, and we're just pleased. And
those softball girls love him.
Cannot thank you guys enough for setting us up here.
They love him to death with this softball program. 6 was the down Wildcat. That was Flowers. Good to see him come off. And is this Showers for the... Yeah, this is Showers. And that PAT is good. That was not Showers. That was Lauricella. Excuse me. Which brings your score, Ponchatoula 14, Wildcat 7. 5:17 here to go in this third quarter from the Swamp, as you see another player with a cramp, and we'll probably be seeing that for the next, maybe the rest of the game, unfortunately.
Well, I mean, when it's hitting everybody right now.
I'd rather it be cramps than some other injury,
right.
So I don't mind
it. You kind of expect it at this point in the season, just starting out, getting ready, but you know, as you go on, you take dehydration breaks, And as you go on, you like to see it kind of dissipate. We'll see what happens as the season progresses, though.
Kind of goes with the territory, as I've misplaced my notes. But anyway, Ponchatoula will be on the road to that so tough Dutchtown team. But Ponchatoula was able to knock them off last year, coming off the Walker loss. They were able to take care of Dutchtown right here at the Swamp. Now they'll have to go to Dutchtown, and they're good again. Walker will be traveling into this 6-5A district at Fountain Blue, and then following up that with a home game against the Mandeville Skippers.
That's what we talk about early on, getting these 5A tests to see where you are.
The litmus test you were talking about.
The litmus test, yep. And also helps you with those power points rack up early too. You can do that too.
So, are you you thinking about your Butch Lee Award candidates?
But right now, I mean,
but it's distinguished.
It's really making it easy for Bishop Davis right here.
Titus Showers in to do the kicking. And there it is. Ball was received inside the 30, but I think that young man had a knee down, which by rule, he's down right there. They're marking him at the 18-yard line. First and 10, Wildcats. 5:16 left to go.
Gotcha. That's correct, yeah. That's both of these touchdowns have come on fourth down. Fourth and one.
Yeah, Ponchatoula scores have become short yardage. Of course, Wildcats scored from 35 out. A pass from Silv to Jones. Silv in the gun. Keeps it himself off right tackle. That's going nowhere.
Not much there.
And it's no surprise. Big Jacoby Berry over there stuffing that up. So it looks like they'll give him a yard. So we'll call it second one. Yeah, second and 9. Silv looks to throw. He's got a receiver. Is that Jones?
Yes.
Caden Jones, he had a step, Rob. He had beaten the defender, but the ball was well overthrown.
Good. Nice separation there by Jones. Just couldn't get it to him.
Ball So we got a good one going here, Rob. Third down 9 for the Wildcats. They need to answer this Ponchatoula score. Pressure on Self completes the pass. See if I can get a number out there. Is that 2?
What do you got? Looks like 2 on the reception.
Rashad Taylor on the reception right at the sticks. They're going to give him that first down. So that was a 9-yard reception. First down, Wildcats moving. Yeah, that 5-5A district that the Wildcats are in now, that's with Dutchtown, EA, Live Oak, Sanamont, and Denham Springs. That's pretty tough.
Every night you just expect those teams to kind of beat up on each other until somebody kind of rises to the top.
Kind of similar to that 6-5A district that Ponchatoula plays in.
Yes, correct. I would probably equate those two to being really similar in the styles of play that they had.
I believe that was McClendon off the right side, 22, yes, and he picks up, give him 3 yards, 2nd and 7 for the Cats. Don't you love it when you misplace notes? McClendon up the middle. Now he's a big bruising back. And that started to take its toll in the middle.
Again, I go back to getting to that second level. You see what
there
happens
it is.
When you get to that second level. That's the thing that Coach Mahaffey wants to see out of McClendon when he gets the ball.
Now, this is so far, this is probably the best sustained drive we've seen from Walker. Of course, they scored on the 35-yarder. They're just marching the ball right now. 1st and 10, Cats from their own 44-yard line. 3:18 to go. Here in the third quarter. Silv in the gun. And timeout.
Timeout.
Wildcats.
There you go.
You're listening to Alfab 17 Local Prep Football.
TSC Logistics. Getting your freight moving toward its destination is as simple as a phone call. 225-248-1573. They're at 111 Founders Drive in Baton Rouge. You can find out more about them at tsclogistics.com.
We're back. Here we go with the Wildcats. Inside handoff to Jones. He's fighting his way. Gets right at midfield. Looks like they're going to spot it right at the 50-yard line. Albert Smith on the tackle. Silv pitches it out. That's Jones around the right side. He's got a first down plus deep into Green Wave territory. Let's see where they're marking this. Looks like he stepped out at the 29-yard line. First and 10, Cats.
That's the little change of pace you get between McClendon and Jones, and they're showing it now. They showed it last week in that opening drive against Denham Springs, and it goes back again. You have a little change of pace. You have a little depth, and they're taking advantage of it right now.
Nifty play. The Ponchatoula pressure came up the middle. They were able to pitch around it, and the pursuit was not there. Silv. Hands off to Jones again, off right side, maybe a yard. Now, Walker started this drive at their own 18-yard line. Tommy's on top of the press box getting hit with balls. Footballs. Don't do that. That's never mind. Okay, here's Silv rolling out to his left. He's going to keep it. Oh, my goodness, and that was a nice lick.
What a hit.
Delivered by Albert Smith, and that's 92. Troy Key Butler, 6'1", 240-pound senior. Brings up 3rd and 5 for Walker. We're coming down to about a minute left here in the third quarter. Quickly moving football game, a lot of running plays. Sill pumps, and he's got a receiver, and he's wide open, and that is a touchdown. Asa Rutherford on the same play
yes.
that went to Jones earlier for the other touchdown. This one was from 30 yards. Call it 29 yards. And that is 6 for the Wildcats, pending this extra point by the big man, Mr. Ponce. Ponchatoula jumped.
Second time on an extra point.
Yeah, this guy in the valley over here. Can't see that number. Is that 5? Is that Wyatt Bennett? Yeah.
Yes.
Bennett jumped a little early. He knew it. He tried to sneak back without. He thought he might be invisible, but they caught that one. So that's half the distance. It's a little closer for Ponce. That's the second time on their extra points they've gotten a little closer, and neither time have they elected to go for 2, which is probably smart. Snap back, and we got fire on this, and 17 is going to be – oh, and he got in.
Wow.
He got in. The holder is number 17, Patrick McKenzie. It was a bobbled snap. Ponchatoula had good penetration. They were going to block that thing. And he ran with it and was able to get it into the end zone for the 2-point conversion, which gives Wildcats their first lead of the night. Your new score, the Walker Wildcats 15, Ponchatoula Green Wave 14. You're enjoying Alfab 17's coverage of local prep football.
The player of the game certificate will be provided courtesy of our friends at the Ponchatoula Times. The Ponchatoula Times, locally owned and operated since 1981. You can find out more about them on Facebook.
Welcome back. And for the first time tonight, Rob, the Wildcats have taken the lead. It's only 1 point, but with 1:17 to go here in the third quarter, the Wildcats have got on top of the Green Wave, 15-14.
That PAT looked like it was going to be disaster for Walker from the beginning, but give Patrick McKenzie making the heads-up play there, taking around the end and getting the 2. Another big thing for these receivers, Walker's looking to replace guys like Ja'Cory Thomas and Warren Young Jr., and that's another big play from their young receivers. Asa Rutherford comes up with that touchdown for them there.
It looks like we're going to have a procedure on the Wildcats while they're resetting this after the penalty. Just to mention, we talked about Rob and Steve Easterling from TSC Logistics. Y'all are doing Glen Oaks and Denham. That should be a good one for you guys. That's next Thursday. For myself, Ham and Howie playing on Friday night. Randy and Mr. Charlie will take that one from Tornado Alley. That's the Tornadoes and Riverdale. And I will be with Mr. Wes Younger for LaRondra and Amy next Thursday. I believe Wes rode with, was it Billy the Kid? No. Who am I thinking of? Who did the Youngers ride with, Tommy? Short kick on the return. See if I can get that number. And that's 23. Fuentes. Fuentes dives forward. They're going to spot this. Let's see where they're spotting this. So Ponchatoula football, 1st and 10 at their own 48-yard line. No, who am I thinking of? The Outlaw. Not Josie Wales. Oh my goodness. Here's Davis around the right side. Look out. He could go. There's the 30. There's 25, 20, 15, 10 inside the 10-yard line. Probably going to mark this at about the 8. They're going to say the 10. Right at the 10. Oh, Colin Farrell played him in the movie. He and his brother, Jesse James. Didn't he ride with the younger boys? Pretty sure he did. Wes Younger, his brother Lance, and we have a timeout on the field. I'm not sure what. Oh, and we have another.
We got a Walker player down.
50 seconds left in this third quarter, and another cramp from Walk. All right, as Travion Thomas jogs off under his own power, another cramp. Not as bad tonight with the cramps as they saw last night with Hammond and Meat. So maybe not as hot, maybe not as humid. I don't know. Them just maybe hydrated better. Nevertheless, 14-15 Walker.
42-yard run by Bishop Davis set this up.
Nice run. That's Cangelosi trying the middle. And this is a first and goal, folks. So they cannot pick up a first down going in. They're going to have to get in the end zone. And we have another stoppage of play.
I don't think we've seen Brazil back
in. I have not seen Brazil back in the game. I'm looking for him on the sideline. I don't see him there either. I see the defense huddling up. Let's see what this is. Ponchatoula's backing up, so there's some kind of penalty. I didn't see the call from the white hat. Did you, Tommy? Yeah, this looks like it was some kind of personal foul. Or let's see if we'll get him to call it again. He's not. Thank you, sir. Appreciate that. So, where are they, Rob? They're at the 20.
Looks like about the 23.
So, it's first and goal from the 23, winding down here in the third quarter. Davis calls for the football. Gives it to Cangelosi right up the middle. Cangelosi, look at that. Fighting all the way down inside the 15-yard line. And that's what they teach these running backs, Rob. You keep those legs churning.
Give Cangelosi the credit for the second effort there because multiple tacklers on there or would-be tacklers, and he just kind of bowled over them.
You got to finish the tackles. Cangelosi, 5'9", 185-pound junior, so they got him coming back next year. And four fingers in the air. That is the end of the third quarter. We're heading to the fourth. Hopefully no more cramps, no more injuries, and we have a whale of a game going on here. We thank you for joining us here, Alfab 17's Prep Football.
Louisiana's headed in the wrong direction, and no one is willing to do what it takes to turn our state around. I'm Gary Talbot. People call me Frog. I'm running to get things done in House District 64. Some say I'm rough around the edges. Well, I've never been afraid to stand up for what's right, whether it was fighting to protect our kids and libraries, for term limits, or for investments in roads and flood mitigation. I have never backed down. Truth is, I've never been okay with the status quo. I'm Frog Talbot, a businessman, a true conservative. Send me to Baton Rouge and I'll fight for you.
The Player of the Game certificate will be provided courtesy of our friends at the Ponchatoula Times. The Ponchatoula Times, locally owned and operated since 1981. You can find out more about them on Facebook.
Hi, I'm Dr. Vinny Mendoza. I'm running for sheriff. I'm from Ponchatoula. I was the assistant to Inspector General of the Air Force, and I have the experience to get the job done. Especially, I know that morale is low. I want to increase the salary of the sheriff's department by 5%. And also, I have a 10-point plan that you can look at VinnyMendoza.com. Thank you.
Okay, and we're back, fourth quarter. Here we go. Don't you love football, Rob?
Yeah, it's football time, man. It's my wife actually said that a couple weeks ago when I left. She goes, it's football season. I'll see you later.
I mean, my first love is baseball. I got to admit. But when it's football season, there's just something special about it.
It's different. It's different. It kind of signals the beginning of a new year, not only for school, but just for these teams and everybody.
And cooler air coming in?
Maybe. Maybe by December, the way this is.
Tommy's on top of the press box, and look, it's nice and cool up there. We're the ones inside in the air conditioner, and we're sweating. It's not the first time I've said Tommy's smarter than I am. ball at the 17-yard line. Davis, he looked to throw, but he tucks it. And he's juking and jiving and trying that right side. Ran out there by, I can't catch that number. Tommy, you see it? Yeah, it looks like Hill and Zion Russ forced him out. So let's see where they have this football. They have it
looks
at
like
the 12?
About the 11 there.
So he picked up about at, 5 or 6.
Look at third and goal from the 11 here.
Third and goal from the 11. Davis. And he got him to jump again.
Jump.
There it is. Look, man, I'll take it all night long. If you're going to give me that. There was obviously a point. There was a point in the ball game last night with Amede and Hammond. Hammond had negative rushing yardages, not negative rushing yardage, but had 3 first downs.
It's the way it works.
Because it was all on penalties.
It happens that way sometimes. This obviously shortens up the field for Ponchatoula.
The from the 6.
Run game's been working all night, man. Why shy away from it?
Third and goal from the 6. Davis sets up his troops. Calls for the football. There it is. And he keeps it himself. He's heading to the corner. Oh, my goodness. What a collision.
What a hit.
The ball came out. Now, I don't see any signals, but they got him marked at the 1-yard line, 4th and goal from the 1. How big is this play for the Greenway?
This would be the third time in this game we've seen this situation.
Unfortunately, we do not see CJ Brazil on the field because he might possibly be the guy they want to go to in this situation. The last time Davis just leaned on his O line, see if he does it again. Nope, he pulled it and came around, and in he goes, and that is a 1-yard touchdown. Walker was expecting him to do that, as I was, and he pulled it and went around the edge and was able to use his athleticism and get in the end zone.
Give Walker credit, they still came down to make the play, but he got in before they could keep him out of there.
Big play for Ponchatoula. That puts them back on top 20-15. Now, are they going to go for 2 here, or are they going to just kick the extra point?
Good question.
2 will make it a 7-point game. They're discussing it.
It's been a heck of a night for Bishop Davis.
I don't see Laura Cella, the kicker. So, yeah, there's Davis. They're going for 2 here, folks. If they get this, that makes it a 7-point ball game. Now, that's supposed to be an automatic call, but I don't understand all the rules. 4, they're not going to snap this. And Coach Willie runs down and calls a timeout. So we got some other action heading this weekend. We were talking about football. We got LSU and Florida State Sunday night, Rob, 7:30, prime time. LSU losing on a blocked extra point last year, which I still have nightmares about. Because you know I love my Tigers. You know, when he's in my ear, I can't bark at you gum at the same time. Tommy, you're killing me. Anyway.
Tommy's letting us know about the Spectrum deal with ESPN.
So I don't know the ins and outs of that.
If you're trying to, evidently, my wife actually told me last night when I got home.
Something to do with Disney, right?
Spectrum has dropped the Disney Networks.
Which is ABC.
Okay. Thank you,
Tommy. Other
way
around. ABC has dropped Spectrum.
ABC has dropped Spectrum.
Thank God I'm on U-verse. So, Tommy Hazelwood on the update.
Thank you, Tommy. I appreciate that.
He's usually on top of things.
All my wife knew was that we couldn't get ESPN anymore. So, if you're on Spectrum, so.
If I couldn't get ESPN, we're going to have a fight.
It's a have to during football season.
I either have it on ESPN or I got it on Discovery Channel or something like that, watching ghosts and buried treasure. Okay, so Davis is split out here wide left, taking the snap. Is that 11, Tommy? 15. That is easily, and he didn't get there.
They stopped him.
So they decoyed Davis way out here to the left. Everybody was assuming something was going to him. easily tried to sneak it in himself and didn't get there. So your score remains Ponchatoula 20, Wildcats 15. 5-point lead here for the Green Wave with 11:04 to go here in this fourth quarter and an exciting football game, Rob.
Credit to Walker defense for recognizing that play on the 2-point conversion coming up for the stop. That's,
absolutely.
That's huge for him at this point.
And, you know, Walker came in here, and I would have to say they were favored, judging from last year. Of course, it's hard to compare two different seasons. But stout-looking team, and Ponchatoula is going punch for punch with them because that's a very good Walker Wildcat football team over there.
I think just watching these teams, I think they're very comparable in what they do and the things they do. Ponchatoula, you hate to say it's a lot more simple with the run game, but they do make things easier on themselves by doing that.
Showers, pooch kick, that's 20. With the football, he's got the edge, and he may go. Cross the 50, 40, 30, he's gone. All the way into the end zone.
Matt, I think it's coming back.
And there are hankies on the field. Much to the dismay of Coach Chad Mahaffey, there is a cramped player at the 25, and the flag is laying at the 20. Now it's at the 26. It was at the 24, but there's no way you could have known that, Tommy. The flag was at the 24. But anyway, you're right, Tommy. The flag is at the 26-yard line. This is going to be some kind of block or hold. And you hate to see that because that young man got the edge and turned on the Jets. That is number 20, Bardalis. And you're familiar with him, Rob.
Yeah, he's a really, really good guy. He won a silver medal over the summer at the AAU Junior Olympics. Also, as you can tell, a track guy. You see that speed right there return.
That was 4.4, 4.5 speed, easy.
He's worked at getting better at both football than he's been doing this. He's one of those guys that seems like he's been here forever, and he's worked on both, and he's really becoming a really good runner on the track as well, as you can tell.
Patrick McKenzie is up under his own power. That was another cramp. And unfortunately for the Wildcats, this backs them up to their own 16-yard line. First and 10 from there, trailing the Green Wave by 5 points here in the Swamp. And these Green Wave fans are starting to feel it. They're starting to get loud. Silv hands the football off. That's McClendon. Nothing doing. Charge led by Krishad LaFrance, 5'9", 315 senior, among others on the interior of that Green Wave line. And I know Coach Willie is pleased with the performance of his D-line to this point.
I guess coming in, that was one of the focal points for Walker when they were scouting against Ponchatoula. It's kind of hard to miss those guys up front.
And you see big LaFrance there, wearing number 0.
Kind of stands out, doesn't it?
It just looks so weird to me. Yeah, do you remember back in the day Ken Burroughs played for the Houston Oilers? He wore 00. Or was that Billy White Shoes Johnson? I think
White
it was Burroughs.
Well, I think White Shoes wore 80, if I remember correctly.
Yeah, I think you're right. There was a Raider.
Jim Otto wore 00 for the Raiders.
So you don't see the 00s anymore, but you're seeing
you're
that.
You're seeing the single 0.
And you're seeing it from big D linemen. Second down, 8 for the Wildcats. 10:21 to go here in the fourth quarter. White Hats were discussing something with Coach Willie and his staff. And we're ready for play. Silv to throw. Underthrown, headed for Jones. That was, I believe that was 29 on the coverage. That was Tyler Rainey on the coverage for the Green Wave.
Jones kind of got twisted around there trying to look for the ball, make the catch.
Now, Silv had some heat on him.
Yes.
He had green jerseys draped all over. third down, 8. Big play for the Wildcats. They need this first down bad.
Got to keep this drive moving.
They don't want to give it right back to the Green Waves at this point. Sill looking to throw. Screen pass. That's McClendon. He hurdles his own player and is going to be stacked up there. That's number one. That's Albert Smith along with Wyatt Bennett. Stuffing that and bringing up a fourth down for the Wildcats. They'll have to punt the ball here. As you see, Mr. White going back to receive this kick from Preston Hill. 9:45 to go.
Just one of those deals trying to get that screen pass and give them a little cushion. Of course, you want the first down. They're going to have to punt. We'll see what happens here.
Just a FYI, Green Wave has one timeout left. Wildcats have two. Snaps back, punts away. Not a bad looking punt.
Not a bad punt at all.
White calls for the fair catch at his own 41-yard line. First and 10, Green Wave from there. So we were talking earlier. Of course, Hammond had that big victory against Amite. You know, it was one thing to beat Amite last year. To validate it with another victory this year was huge for the Hammond program. And like I said, that game was a war. An absolute war. It was 13-13 midway through the fourth quarter. And Hammond was able to pull away later. Now, Coach Buckles flew out to Dallas first thing this morning because his brother Carlton is the defensive backs coach at TCU, who's taking on Colorado tomorrow. That's Coach Prime. I believe that's P on the carry, and that play's going nowhere. And I believe that was 34, Austin Makowitz. Am I saying that right?
Nice pursuit there on that play.
Stuffed that for a 2-yard loss. Now, we're on the sideline. If you look there, that is number 14. That is C.J. Brazil. He's got his helmet on. And hopefully for Ponchatoula, he can get back into the game and is healthy. Davis calls for the football. Hands it to P. P picks up 4-5 yards. You know, P is not a very large young man. Let's see if I get his dimensions here. Jacob P. Well, yeah, they got him listed at 175, but he looks kind of small out there. And the thing with those smaller guys, we have a few on the Hammond team, they kind of get lost in between all those big trees.
That's exactly what I was. You get that low center of gravity and start moving and going forward. Let the momentum carry. That's kind of what you saw on that run right there.
And what you get is, I'm not sure about P's speed. I'm sure he's fast. But there's those little guys are shifty.
Right.
And they get in there and they can create yards. And P's doing a good job of that.
You got to start looking for him.
Davis is, looked like Wildcats had him bottled up.
I swear I thought they had him right in the middle, and he just kind of pushed it back outside there. And that, looks like we got possibly another cramp here.
He's getting up, I believe. And that's what you get from Davis. You think you got him stopped. If you don't wrap him up and get him down, he can burn you because that was set up for a 1-yard loss. Instead, it looks like he got it back to the original line of scrimmage. However, it is a fourth down for the Green Wave at their own 45-yard line. And Coach Willie is opting to punt the football here, I do believe. Under 10 seconds on the play clock with only one timeout to go. He's going to have to snap this quick or it's going to cost him 5. And Coach Willie decides to take his third and final timeout. That drains their timeout bank.
I'm not sure they wanted to take that timeout.
They did not, and Coach Willie's not happy about it.
Yeah, you can see Coach Willie's kind of reaction down there. That's it just looks like a not the ideal situation of what they were looking for.
They were late making up their mind if they were going to go for this or punt, and by the time they got the guys out there, there just wasn't enough time left. And, you know, that's time management, and just like with players, coaches, referees, us, you know, we're still getting in the groove of things, too, you know?
I'm learning. I can't tell you how many. I think I've talked to every coach in Livingston Parish for football, and it's exactly what you said. It's not just about us and our X's and O's and how we execute. It's us as a coaching staff, how we relate to each other, how we do things on a Friday night, and how we work the sidelines, knowing who's supposed to be where, who's supposed to be doing what. It's a
complex, whole lot of moving parts.
It's a complex picture for everybody, and somehow it all comes together on Friday night.
And for the average football fan, they probably aren't aware of what all goes into this to prepare for a football game. It is a lot of work, and these coaches earn their money.
Tommy pointed
that
out.
And that is a snap over his head, and that is, oh my goodness. Let's see, who made that tackle? Was that 39 again? I believe it was. Preston Hill corrals the punter for Ponchatoula, who is Ethan Lorsella, who does the PATs and the field goals. And unfortunately for the Green Wave, a huge loss. Massive play.
That's one of those plays, and it goes back to, like I said, special teams is another layer that you've added to the, I guess, complexity that we were talking
right,
about.
Exactly.
It's there, and these are the miscues that you might see early. Hopefully you get that ironed out as the season goes on.
Well, they talk about it all the time. You got three facets of the game. You got to win two to win a football game. Sometimes you got to win all three. Wildcats, deep in Green Wave territory. That is McClendon plowing ahead all the way down to about the seven-yard line.
7 yard line, yeah.
McClendon's having a heck of a game. He is good-looking back.
This is kind of what they wanted to see from C.J. McClendon. He's had a couple of years where you start to see flashes, and it looks like things are starting to come together for him.
Well, and I tell you, from my perspective, if you can run like that against that defensive line, you got something. Greenies rise to the occasion.
They bottled them up right there.
McClendon might have lost a yard on that one. Third down.
Still got him at the 7 there.
Still at the 7, so no gain. Big play coming here. Silve in the gun. Flanked by McClendon. McClendon has the ball. Up the gut. Not much. I'd love to be able to tell you a tackler, but my eyes ain't that good.
It's a mass of bodies down there.
Bunch of green jerseys all over.
Mass of bodies.
Now, we are just under 6 minutes, which tells me that we are going to hydration break. And when we come back, probably the biggest play of the game
yes,
coming.
No doubt.
This is Alfab 17's coverage of local prep football. I'm Matt Greer, along with Rob DeArmond and our good buddy up top, Tommy Hazelwood.
TSC Logistics. Getting your freight moving toward its destination is as simple as a phone call. 225-248-1573. They're at 111 Founders Drive in Baton Rouge. You can find out more about them at tsclogistics.com.
I'm Ponchatoula Police Chief Reed Larrison, and on behalf of myself and our department, we would like to wish our Ponchatoula High football team some great success this year. Good luck to you. We look forward to supporting you. We pray that you have a successful season and that none of our athletes experience any significant injuries. To our seniors, those younger classmen are looking up to you. Please provide them with the leadership. Continue to push yourself to be the best that you can be, and go get us that state championship. Good luck, God bless, and go Green Wave.
And we're back, and in my opinion, Rob, this is one of those plays.
You are correct.
This is pivotal.
This is the play of the ball game right here.
Ponchatoula fans up on their feet. Quick snap to Sylvie. He takes it himself, and he's right at the sticks. I think he's got it. Looks like they're bringing him down inside the 5.
That's, it looks like they're going to put it at the 4 right here.
At the 4, that's right. And they're dropping the sticks. First and goal, Wildcats. Gut check time for the Green Wave. Leading by 5, under 6 minutes to go, clock running. Ponchatoula is out of timeouts. Wildcats still have 2 of theirs. First and goal from the 4. Silve. In the gun, flanked by McClendon. Motion by Jones. McClendon up the middle. Tough running inside. He might have got a yard, maybe.
Looks like no gain right there from where they're spotting it.
Lake and Jordan on the tackle. Coming down to 5 minutes left to go. Silv gets the play from the sideline. They are taking their time. Play clock coming down to 10 seconds. Jones in motion. Gets the football. Tries to cut it in. No, sir. Not happening.
Nice job by the Ponchatoula defense to pursue and make the tackle.
Jacob Robinson made the initial contact to slow him down. And then big number 99, Jacoby Berry, mopped it up. I would not want to be tackled by that man. Loss of one, ball at the five. What's your play call, Mr. DeArmond?
Oh, my goodness. Can we try to go play action here, maybe?
I tell you, I was thinking the same. Bobble snap, pitches it out. Ball's loose. Ponchatoula has the football. Turnover. Big Troy Key Butler comes up with one of the plays of the game. Now, it was a bad snap. Sill tried to pick it up and pitch it out. I believe that was Jones out there waiting for the football. And Ponchatoula read it, was all over it. It had no chance. And as a result, Green Wave have the football. Now, there is some discussion on the field. I'm curious to know what they're talking about. I don't see flags. Do you? Oh, it's Ponchatoula's ball without a doubt. Was there something after? I'd like to know what they're discussing.
Absolutely play the game right there.
Yeah, that was huge for Ponchatoula. If they go on to hold on to win this football game, they're going to point to that play. And I'm not sure what the delay was there. Maybe it was where they were going to spot it. Looks like the ball, Tommy's saying, 6.5 yard line. First and 10, Greenway, 4:04. Here to go in the fourth quarter. Here we go. That man, Davis, calling for the football. Keeps it himself. Go figure. Makes a move. Look out. Brings it out to about the 14-yard line. 8 yards, and we're going to have another cramp. You can see the frustration. Number seven is down. That is TJ Silvio. Familiar with that young man?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
He's one of the linebackers, one of the playmakers.
He's battled some injuries, but, you know, this is one of those seasons where Coach Mahaffey is hoping he can be healthy and be productive for this defense. Good-looking young man, good-looking player when he's out there, and obviously looking to make a contribution.
So high school action's in swing. We've had all kind of college action. It'll really ramp up tomorrow. Looking forward to Jaheim Johnson. Getting on the field with Tulane tomorrow. I forget who they're playing. It escapes me right now. But anyway, he was our kid that graduated last year. Great young man. And he's down at Tulane now. Still a ways to go till we get to pros. We got the Saints and the Titans in the Dome on September 10th. That's a noon kickoff. Are the Saints down to their 53-man roster yet?
I believe they made last cuts earlier this week, but they're still kind of tweaking rosters from here on out. So
looking at just, what players
keep,
other teams cut.
And seeing what's going to happen as you go.
So it should be an interesting dynamic with the Saints this year. I like what I saw in preseason. Carr, I've never been a big Carr fan, but I'm kind of starting to dig him.
Kind of digging it, huh?
Yeah. So here we go. Silvio walks off on his own power. That's good to see. We're under 4 minutes to go here. Davis, he is turning around watching the play clock. 28, 27, taking every second. And this is just smart. Yeah, he could look down there. But he's probably going to take this under 10 seconds.
Either way, if you're Ponchatoula, that's a good spot to be in at this point.
Now, you don't want this to backfire on you either. God forbid something goes wrong here. Davis takes it himself up the middle. Look out 40-yard line, 45, and he goes down there and stays in bounds. Stays in bounds. That is a heady play by that young man. He goes out of bounds. That clock stops. Well, it's going to stop on the first down anyway.
They got to move it anyway, but that's just knowing that situational football and knowing what you're supposed to do in that situation.
And that is senior leadership, and that's what you get with Davis. He's just so impressive. And that play might have broke the Wildcats back. We'll see. We're under 3 minutes. Green Wave milking the clock for everything it's worth. It's down to 5. Snap. And there's CJ Brazil back in the football game. That's good to see. He's no gain on that carry. And Wildcats are going to have to start considering using their timeouts, Rob.
So, and that was about a 33-yard pickup on that run, too. To kind of
nice run.
Up. But, yeah, you're right, man. You're absolutely right. At this point, got to figure out what you want to do. If you're the defense, do you want to take these timeouts right now and use them? Or do you want to conserve them in case you get the ball back?
Of course, if the Greenway picks up another first down, this thing's pretty much all she wrote. You wouldn't happen to have a loose yardage on Davis?
Since we got to the second half, no, I don't.
That's okay. I know you got your hands full. That's Brazil again up the middle. Stuffed, no gain. Looks like they're giving him one maybe. I don't think so. That's no gain. Third and 10. Green Wave at their own 47-yard line. I don't know. I would take one here because you got a third and 10 situation. I would have taken a timeout there because chances are Ponchatoula is going to be pretty generic on this play. They're going to keep it safe and punt the football. They want to give the Wildcats as little amount of time as possible. There's Davis. Look out. And that's it. That's going to do it. That is Davis. He is into Wildcat territory, all the way down to the 39-yard line, and that's a backbreaker, Rob.
That's, like you said, that's pretty much going to do it right there. Puts him in a Walker territory, and we'll see what happens there.
I think our Butch Lee Memorial Award for Player of the Game is kind of a no-brainer.
Yes.
I don't think – do we have to talk about this?
I don't think we have to debate on that.
And that will be Mr. Davis. He did win it a couple times last year. He's that kind of player. Bishop Davis, our Butch Lee Memorial Award Player of the Game here in the Swamp. As it appears, Ponchatoula is going to hold on to knock off a Walker Wildcat team that took Ponchatoula pretty much to the woodshed last year.
This is just, like I said, these are these tests that you want to see early. And you're getting those big tests and you're seeing what your teams are made of.
Sure.
You know, a Ponchatoula come away with a win here. They're going to learn something about themselves. Walker's going to, looks like, get the loss here, but they're going to learn something about themselves as well. So,
no doubt.
Every game you play in, I think there's a lesson to be learned, and both of them are learning.
And even though this is a loss, as it appears, for the Wildcats, they're going to learn from this. This is probably going to make them better.
No doubt.
If I had to guess.
No doubt. And you got to remember, it's only week one.
Ponchatoula. Watch this. There it is. Neil, 45. One timeout left to go for the Wildcats.
He just took away from that yardage total.
He did. He's messing your yardage up, man. I'd like to mention one more time our underwriters for tonight, because without these folks, we couldn't bring you this stellar first-rate broadcast.
I'm
with
still
zero
working
mistakes.
On it, man. I'm still working.
Mr. Vinny Mendoza, candidate for Tanspo Parish Sheriff. Gary Frog Talbert, candidate for State Rep, District 64. Ponchatoula Chief of Police, Chief Bree Larrison. The Ponchatoula Times, TSC Logistics. And, of course, the Livingston Parish News, your community news source since 1898. How was that?
Appreciate it.
Think the editor liked that one?
Appreciate that.
Shame on me for not mentioning Southeastern.
We were getting there. I wanted to say
thank you.
Southeastern will be at Mississippi State.
Who? We have a football team called Northwestern. Northwestern Demons and ULL are going to lock horns tomorrow. Tyrone Lewis, ex-Hammond High standout player, is starting free safety for them. Congratulations to Tyrone. He got married. He has a new baby. Beautiful baby. Saw him at Hot August Nights in Hammond the other night. He is a physical specimen and just a great kid, and we wish him the best of luck with the Cajuns. And we wish luck to the Demons, too. I'll wear that hat you gave me, Tommy. So Ponchatoula backing themselves up to midfield. This doesn't do wonders for their stat line, but a win is a win is a win, and that's what's most important to Coach Willie and most of these Ponchatoula fans, and they will take it as we count it off. Under 5 seconds, and the party is beginning here in Ponchatoula. Last year started their season with a pretty rough loss to this Wildcat team, and tonight they host the Wildcats, and they hold on for a 20-15 well-earned victory. Go ahead, Rob.
Heck of a game, man. Just heck of a game. This is a
entertaining game. It is now 9:30 at night.
Right about 9:30.
There's still Miller time left, and
I think if you're both coaches here, this is exactly what you're looking for. Obviously, if you're walking, you want to come away with a win. But
sure,
you both get tested in these types of games, especially early.
Any loss, a coach is going to be disappointed. But I believe Coach Mahaffey is going to be able to look at this and break this game down and find some really positive things, especially the running of Brazil. And that little play-action pass that he hit Jones, and again the other one for the touchdowns, those plays had Ponchatoula goofed.
Like I said, those receivers are guys that are looking to step up. They lost two big players from last year, and they obviously that's something they got to build on. Two guys that are looking to kind of fill that gap, and they got the production tonight, so something to build on there.
So as we said, Walker heading to Fountain Blue tomorrow night before coming back to their place to host Mandeville in week 3. Ponchatoula will be hitting the road heading to Dutchtown. And that's going to be rough.
It's a test for both of them.
Yeah, good test.
Road test there for them. And Dutchtown, we know about them playing in that district with Denham and Live Oak and Walker. So we'll get a taste of what's going on there, too, at Dutchtown.
Both schools getting trial by fire early, and I think it'll serve them both well down the stretch. I look for Walker to rebound from this and put together a quality season and return to the playoffs. Ponchatoula definitely has the talent. They have the coaching staff to get them there. They have the support of this community. Ponchatoula is second to almost no one in support for this program, this high school, and those kids know it. And you'll see that as they sing the Ponchatoula alma mater here. I know the words. I'm not going to break out in song. I don't want to run off what few viewers we have left, and Tommy will fire me. But this is always a tradition here at Ponchatoula. They put their hands in the air and sing the Ponchatoula alma mater.
Walker doing the same thing on their side.
And Walker's over there singing theirs with their band. You love to see this.
Got a little high school athletics.
The school pride, man. There's just nothing like it. And for Rob DeArmond and Tommy Hazelwood, I'm Matt Greer. We're just so pleased to be able to be here and bring this to you. Of course, I won't be here every weekend. I'll be with my team mostly on Friday nights, but I'll pop in from time to time, keep Tommy straight. And, yeah, I will see you next Thursday, and I'll see you guys. Well, I'll see Charlie and Randy at Tornado Alley next Friday as our Tornadoes take on Riverdale. Hopefully, we end up 2-0 from there. So congratulations to Coach Willie and the Ponchatoula Green Wave. Rob, thanks for
appreciate
doing this with me, sir.
Thanks for the opportunity.
You and I go back a long ways.
Really long way. I don't think there was a time in my life I didn't know somebody named Greer. So.
We used to run the roads down there at Orange Street Park.
A little bit, just a little bit.
Down on Chestnut in East Illinois and got into all kinds of trouble. Well, I got in more trouble than you did. But we had good memories nonetheless. And
No doubt.
Your dad and my dad were good friends, so it's funny how it culminates. How it all comes around. And so for our folks that I just mentioned, this is Alfab 17's coverage of local prep football. We'll be coming at you all year, and we'd like to congratulate Mr. Davis on the Butch Lee Memorial Award Player of the Game. He definitely earned it, and he gets that gift certificate for a seafood platter at Hookie's. I'm going to have to go check this place out because it sounds pretty doggone good, and Lord knows I'm not a stranger to eating. Good eating. That's what Tommy said. That's good eating. That's in my earpiece.
There you go.
So thank you for joining us tonight, and we will be seeing you next week. We got three games coming up. Take your pick. They all should be dandies. So thank you and good night. We love you.